Hey, Jody here.
We're welding a root pass today, stainless steel flange, carbon steel pipe. We're going to be talking about some purge tips for tack welds, as well as the entire weld out, some techniques for putting the root in there, as well as some nice, instructive, clear arc shots. First thing is to make sure everything's clean. No mill scale on the carbon steel side. 1/8 inch gap, feathered edges, no land. Now to get a purge on this, before I put tack welds on it, I'm going to need either two cylinders with a flow meter on each or a dual flow meter. I've been trying out this Spark brand dual flow meter now for several months, and I just added it to the store. Good for purging, good for running two welders. This one comes with enough fittings where you can use either hose clamps with your own hose or a regular inert gas hose. I'm using the regular inert gas fittings today. Once I got it hooked up, I got one side hooked up to my machine, the other side hooked up to a purge line. I'm using this little purge box here to get tacks on so I don't have to tape up and wait on a purge. Little argon boxes like this are really common in aerospace. This is one that I made and used when I was doing aerospace work. Look what a good job it does on shielding the tack. And it's immediate. You don't have to wait. As soon as you turn the argon on, you got a purge. After all the tacks are feathered with a grinder, except for one, I let it purge for 5 minutes at 25 CFH. Here's a little close-up of my TIG gloves that I added to the store some months ago. The technique I'm going to be showing goes forward and back, not side to side, so I'm wearing a TIG finger for that. That's the technique I'm using today. 1/8 inch gap, 95 amps for the root. This is the technique, basically. Forward and back with very little side-to-side motion. Walking the cup is a great way, but you can't always walk the cup. I'm just showing this particular technique that has always worked for me, for stainless roots as well as carbon. Lay wire, 1/8 rod, 1/8 gap, only forward and back motion, no side to side. It's difficult to do that walking the cup. Here I'm coming up, tying into a tack, so I'm slowing down, kind of soaking the heat in there, make sure everything melts and blends together nice before I snap out of it. I didn't mention it early, but I'm basically just keeping everything taped up here and only leaving open the areas that I'm going to weld to an extent. Here I'm going to show the technique when I don't feather a tack. If you're coming up off the bottom or off the side, this is a technique that works for me. Basically, what I'm going to do is just really quickly fuse the wire to the tip of the tack, back up a couple of ripples, pause for about a second, and then forward and back and blend everything in together. And I'll show you that tie-in here in just a minute. I didn't touch that with a grinder, and it's still going to work out just fine. Now, that's only coming off of a tack. I do like to have a tack feathered that I'm welding into, so that it makes sure and gets full penetration and blends nicely into the tack that I'm welding into. So again, forward and back, keeping a little pressure on the wire, 95 amps, pressure on the wire so that it doesn't keyhole, so that it keeps the puddle kind of satisfied. And now I'm welding into that feathered area of the previous tack, slowing down and then trailing out, snapping out, catching my tape on fire, putting it out with argon. There is the tack of where I started without a feathered tack, right there. There's the tie-in. I don't usually feather my tacks a whole lot on a stainless joint like this, so I'm going to show you now the same exact technique on a tack, coming off a tack where I feathered it a little bit. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to go ahead and get that wire fused in there so that it doesn't keyhole when I get there, back up a little bit, and then move forward and back, keeping a nice tight arc. Forward and back, very little side to side. If I come up on the very top and things are a little hot, I'll definitely move a little bit side to side. But for the most part, it's just forward and back. And then it's always a good practice to speed up, kind of comet trail out up on the wall of the bevel instead of on the root pass. I'm using the lift arc function on the TIG welder today. I've got a foot pedal and everything, but I'm not using it today. I'm just using the lift arc. Now that I'm ready to close this thing up, this is the last little 1-inch section, I'm reducing my flow to about 10 CFH, and I got to make sure that I have a vent at the uppermost point, and I'll explain that in just a second.
Let me show you this little demonstration I did a while back using a water jug. It really drives the point home of why you need a vent at every uppermost area in whatever you're trying to purge.
It really helps to think of argon as water. It's heavier than air, so it goes to the bottom and displaces the air. If you've got an area like this with nowhere for it to vent, it's going to be trapping air and swirling around, and you're not going to get a pure argon purge. So what you need is a vent. Just cutting a little hole in here, a little vent hole, allows things to fill up. It would allow that argon to completely displace the air and allow you to get a good purge. Well, let's close this thing up. There's only about an inch here. We've already seen plenty of arc shots. I increased the amperage to 105 here. That's up 10 from what I welded the rest of it. That's because this had started to close up, so it's more like a 332 gap there. I need a little bit more heat to make sure I break the walls down. Then when I tie in and snap out, take a little quick peek at it. Stay tuned for the hot pass and cover pass coming up in a video pretty soon. Here's some little teaser shots for that. Let me quickly go over the products used in this video. This is the Spark Dual Flow Meter. These are my new TIG gloves, not really that new anymore. I searched for a long time to find some durable yet really comfortable TIG gloves. This is my TIG Finger product that just excels on things like this, on stainless steel pipe, lets you prop right next to the weld and finish that pass without roasting your fingers.